Wondering how the F1 interviews for fall 2021 are going? This video is going to be a real F1 interview experience of a student who recently gave his interview at the Chennai Embassy, and there is so much to learn from his experience, so keep on watching. Hi guys, my name is Shachi and I'm a travel and a visa coach. On this channel, you will find lots of useful videos for the F1 visa process. We have an entire playlist on this, so make sure that you check them out. For today's video, I have with me Pawan Bhairwani. Pawan recently gave his F1 visa interview from the Chennai Embassy and his visa was approved. So he is here today to share his D-Day experience, and he also has some really useful interview prep tips. So before we get into his interview experience, here's a quick snapshot of Pawan's profile. So education, he has completed his engineering in mechanical field. Work experience, he has a total of 6 years of work experience with Bharat Petroleum. In the field of supply chain and operations. Admit. His admit is from Ohio State University for their MBA program. He plans to specialize in operations management. And funding. His program is fully funded. He has secured 100% funding for both the years of his program. Now, as you can see, Pawan's profile is actually quite strong. And in spite of this, he prepared really hard for his interview and he was really, really thorough. We worked together through consultation session and also he took a mock interview, and all of this really paid off and his visa was approved. So in this video, he's here to share his experience and he also has some really useful tips. So let's jump right into the video.
Hi Pawan, congratulations.
Thank you. I work for Bharat Petroleum. I have 6 years of work experience. I applied for MBA program last year, but because of COVID, the consulates was closed. Then my university decided to defer my admission. So I'll be joining Fisher College of Business, that is from the Ohio State University, Columbus.
Yeah.
So they offered me a full scholarship depending on my profile and my GMAT score. So they offered the same thing last year, and on my deferral also, they took a stand that they'll maintain it. The last year I deferred, I had a visa interview on 2nd and 4th of May that got cancelled because of COVID. Then again, after a lot of struggle and hustle, I got an interview date on 28th of June.
Correct. Yes.
So on 27th was my OFC and on 20th was my VA, VAC, visa appointment. Mm. 27th, the process was very chilled out. So what you have to do is you have to just carry your 3 documents, DS-160, your passport and your appointment confirmation. So they'll allow you, they'll take a photo of yours, and it's a very normal process. No questions asked. It's just a formality you have to do. The second day what happened is my interview was at Chennai Center. So it was at 10 a.m. I reached there by 9 a.m. But the thing was that they were not allowing. They'll not allow you to enter before your appointment time.
Right, yeah.
So on 10 o'clock, they asked us to wait outside. And a lot of students were waiting. Some had interviews at 12, 1, they were also waiting. So they allowed us at 10. And after that, you have to go. They will do a scanning like they do in airports. After that, you have to go inside. So I reached the place where the interview happens. I reach at 11 o'clock. So
okay.
1 hour the process will take, like from line, from scanning till the time you reach the center where the interview is happening, it will take about 1 hour. So 11 okay. o'clock sharp, I reach there. The phones and all are not allowed. So in OFC, you can take your phone because there is a locker out there. So it's a private locker. But for Chennai, people who are in Chennai, don't carry any phones, watches also. If it's a metallic watch, don't take it. Mm-hmm. So I did not have any phone. I did not have any watch. That's because
just your documents. That's it. Okay.
So 11 o'clock, I reached there. So at that time, 4 counters are open. And majority of all the students were F1. So in Chennai, what happens is if you get a visa, they'll give you a green slip. Unlike in Bombay, where they'll give you a white slip. So mm-hmm. I was just seeing that how many people are getting green slip.
Right.
So the percentage was quite decent. I think that I would have seen near about 40 to 50 students who are passing by me. Mm-hmm. And except 2 or 3, everyone was having a green slip.
Okay.
Then I went inside. So the thing is that the interview room is like, it's a soundproof room. So you cannot hear something from outside. So there are 2 very heavy doors which you have to pull. So you cannot hear anything. So once you go inside, you will be able to hear something. And because they were maintaining social distance, then what happens is the number of people in the room are very limited. So I think the line was 5 and 4 people were in the counter. So at any point of time, I think 9 to 10 people will be in the room in which the interview was happening. So what happened is in the OFC, what they'll do is they'll paste a barcode. So on your passport.
On the passport, backside.
So what happened for me is because I had submitted my DS-160 at the last moment. I submitted on 25th and my interview was on 28th. So they were not able to read it. So the visa officer told me that there is a counter nearby. Just go there and inform him that, that the officer is not able to read this. So I just went there and he took about 3 to 4 minutes and he did something. I think some thing he did in the system. Then I reached the interview, like the place when interview was happening. So the interview was very brief. And in Chennai, the interviews are having very, very brief. So the people who I see maximum 1 minute to 1.5 minutes they'll speak. For me, they have spoken only to 30 seconds. Only 3 or 4 questions they asked. So he was an American guy, a thin guy with some blonde hair. So okay. First he asked me that, which year you graduated? Then I told that I graduated in 2015. Then he asked me that, so it's your university fully funded. So you told me that to clearly mention it's fully funded for both the years.
Correct.
After that, he just asked me that, what does your father do? I was just about to tell that what my father does, but he cancelled that question. Like
because you were question. Funded.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Then he asked me, what are your plans after MBA? So I just told that after my MBA, I want to come back to India and work for so-and-so company. Then he said, okay, your visa is approved, follow the quarantine rules.
So work for so-and-so companies, as in like, did you make it specific with sector and link it to your program or how did you answer this?
So the thing is that the mock which we had, so I was fully prepared. So I was prepared for anything about OPT, anything he asked.
Hi Pawan, good evening.
Hi ma'am.
Can you tell me a little bit about yourself? Why do you feel you need an MBA after 6 years of working in supply chain? How do you want to grow your career? What is the field you plan to enter? How many admits did you get? Why did you pick Ohio State out of the 5 admits? Do you have any other family funding to help you or your own personal savings? Did you not find a similar MBA program in India? Because you work with Government of India, right? So why go to the US now? Is OPT part of the course? Do you have OPT option after the course?
Yeah, after my course, I have a 3 years of OPT.
Do you plan to avail that?
Yeah. One day before, I messaged you also that should I update my LinkedIn or not? Because I read in some interview that maybe they can check your LinkedIn profile, Facebook profile.
Yes.
So whatever you are saying, it should match, right?
Correct. This is what many of my videos also have told us that especially if you're working, right, your LinkedIn profile needs to be updated and match your DS-160.
Yeah. So what happened is I was very specific. Like before the mocks, I was like, I should give that I'll come back to India and work in India, but it's always better to be specific. So I had proper companies in mind. So I went a step ahead. Like with you, I discussed the positions in which I went to work. Like just before one day in which OFC was there, I called a couple of friends who were working in those companies.
Okay.
I called a fellow who was working in Oran, like what posts are there and how the company works.
Yeah.
That will help you like with the positions. And if anything, he wants to like Google it, so you will resonate with the searches. Your story will resonate with the searches. And the thing was that I was not hiding anything. So I was like, fine, what I have to say, it's the truth. And I took a lots of documents, like all financials, all my, nothing was asked. They are not interested. I think the first question was more about seeing your confidence that which year you graduated. So you have to be very precise. Nothing here and there, only one date I spoke to her.
Right. Okay.
No college, not the degree which I have done. I was to the point.
Okay.
Then the last question was like, it took about 20 seconds, rest all were rapid fires. Like he asked me, so you're funded. I just told, yes, I am funded for both the years. So the thing is that for MBA candidates, I can just say like the questions, like the same questions we face in our MBA interview. It's not like MS. We have to go through a essay.
Interview process. Rigorous, right.
It's a rigorous interview process.
Correct.
So for that, I had my answers prepared, but those answers are elaborative, right? So like in my mock, you would have heard my mock, it was very elaborate answers, and that we do it because we want our MBA person who's taking our interview to know our background. So we put the masala in that. But here you don't have to put.
Yeah.
That was something I was missing. Then again, to how to make it precise, that I learned from the interview. And that OPT question and few questions like I was never expecting that someone can ask me in a mock. So that you asked. So because all the interviews which you read in Telegram, many people will not pose their answers. And even if they pose, it's not how they are sounding. They'll write it. You can read the question and decide what you want to speak. But until and unless someone hears you, you will not get a third ear to comment how they're hearing.
I think that's the objective, right? With every mock to like literally put you in that place where you can feel the interview pressure. You know, where you can really feel that, okay, there is a consequence to what I'm going to say.
Yeah.
And then test yourself as to how prepared you are.
Yes. And like if you if you do a mock with a person whom you know, obviously it helps. It helps you. He will give you. But like giving a mock to a third person, it's a neutral situation. Like he'll not. You will try to impress her, right?
Or yes.
You will try to impress the person who's taking an interview.
Okay.
So, but it's not like an MBA interview. It's all good until and unless something bad happens. So it's always better to take it.
And one thing I think which I wanted to ask you, and which a lot of people would be also interested to know, is how did you get a fully funded program? Like, what was the criteria? And if somebody is looking at such type of opportunities, what should they really work on their profile?
So for me, like one is your GMAT score, right? Because GMAT is a standardized test. So many in COVID, many people have waived from the GMAT. Don't take that option that give your GMAT, because that will help you to give your credibility, like you are a good student, right? So what happens is it's a give and take relationship for a college. College wants their ranking to improve. If they see some value in you that you will add to the college, suppose a GMAT score, suppose you have a decent GMAT score, then you will uplift the GMAT score of that college, the average GMAT score. Now, how that will help your college is it will boost their rankings in various platforms. The second thing is that your career goals should match. Like for a college, what are the factors for their ranking is how much international students they have, what is their average GMAT score, and how many people are getting employed. So you have MBA process is quite different from MS. You have to be very clear that what you want to do, like after your MBA, which profile you are wanting. Generally, it's a question that why MBA, why this college, and what are your goals? The college which I am going is it's ranked 4th for supply chain and management. And I was wanting to do it. So you have to be very clear. The college should see that yes, they can. If you come to this college, you will get a job. So that their numbers are not jacked up.
Their placements look good. And
you should post up the college to help in their rankings. And right, they want you to come, so they will give you a scholarship. The thing is that from India, a lot of people applying, point number one. And a lot of people are male engineers and from an IT field, or like from me, from an operations background. Some actor is there. Suppose he applies, he'll get, or if someone is from Navy or someone is an IS officer, with a low GMAT score also, he'll get an interview call. But you will not get, because you are already from a pool which is very competitive.
Right.
To break that pool, the thing is...
You need something else. Okay.
Many colleges will say that we see the holistic picture, we see everything. But the first barrier is GMAT score. Again, the thing is that with a less GMAT score and a good profile, you will get scholarship. It's not like if your story is very good, you will get it. But like people think that I work for an NGO, this is my story. So it's very common. Like all the people who are applying to US, they have worked for an NGO.
Work for NGO, right.
So that all will not help you out, because I have worked for United Nations. Like I was in their volunteer program. I have a company who do theaters. Like we do ticketed shows.
Okay.
So that all did not help me much as far as my GMAT score.
All right. Okay.
And the thing is that after your placements also, if you are applying to consultancy, like the big three firms in consultancy, they see your GMAT score. Not very openly said. Not very openly said, but the admission committee also of the interview, they all will say that we look at the overall picture. Yes, they do look at the overall picture, but you belong from a pool which is overly applying, right?
Correct. Yeah.
For engineering. So that's if you are in a competitive pool, you have to be on your toes on your GMAT.
Great. So thank you so much for sharing this experience, and I think you do amazing work. So.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks for all the help.
So I hope Pavan's interview experience has helped you get an idea of how F1 visa interviews are looking this year and what's the kind of preparation that you need to put in. If you have any more questions for Pavan, feel free to reach out to him. His LinkedIn profile is in the description box below, so you can reach out to him via LinkedIn. Also, if you would like to take a mock interview with me, feel free to do that. The link to register for the mock interview is also in the description box. This is going to be a mock which is going to be exactly like the actual visa interview. We'll do it on a Zoom call, and the mock will be followed by a detailed analysis and answer structuring session. This has helped many, many students, and I'm sure it's going to help you as well. So go ahead and register for your mock before your actual visa interview. If you have any more questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section below. You can also DM me on Instagram. My Instagram handle is at shachi.mal. And there are lots of more useful resources for you. There are tons of free useful resources. These are free PDFs, which consist of document checklist, they consist of D-Day checklist, and all these will help you prepare for the main day. So do check out these free resources. The link is in the description box. And if you want to be part of my next F1 prep interview workshop, you can register for that as well. So all these good things in the description box, do take a look. And signing off for now, I'll see you on the next one. Wishing you all the best for the road ahead. Bye.